It's nice meeting you, Miss
Nice to meet you.
Finally. It's such an honor to be talking to you face to face.
Yeah.
When you first released As Tears Go By, that's the year when I was born.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's 1964.
Yeah.
And I really want to tell you in person that Broken English and Strange Weather really changed my life. It changed my outlook in life, music, and love, and now I view misery differently because of these two masterpiece albums.
That's wonderful, thank you.
Thank
it's
you.
Kind of what I wanted, yeah.
Yeah, how are you doing? Welcome
I'm
to
really home. Well, I'm healthy and strong and getting ready for my world tour.
Okay, your first time to Hong Kong, that's
yes.
what I heard.
Yes.
You've only been to other Asian countries like Japan.
Yes. Yeah.
What do you feel about the spectacular skyline?
So amazing. The buildings are so amazing. And the way they use light on the buildings, the neon, is
yeah.
incredible.
Yeah. I've been listening to your new album, Horses and High Heels.
Yeah.
And apart from the very trademark Marian Faithful kind of melancholy, beautiful melancholy,
yeah.
and also emotional complexities, surprisingly, I find that you sounded very contented in your album.
Yeah.
And I read an interview recently saying that you are at a stage in your life when you finally found happiness.
I
Is
know.
That right?
Yes. Yeah. Well, if you know my...
Because we miss the miserable...
I know. Some people do, yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Some people seem to have an investment in it. Yeah. Well, be that as it may, life goes on, and my life got better and better.
Good for you.
And I'm feeling very happy at the moment.
Okay, good for you. Okay, tell me about your new album, Horses and High Heels.
Yeah.
There are four new songs, and one of them is called Why Did We Have to Part?
Yeah.
I heard that it was about your recent breakup.
It's a breakup song, yes.
Okay. Does breakup get any easier? The older you get, the wiser you
Maybe
get?
Maybe a little easier, yeah. You get over it quicker.
Really?
I think so.
It still hurts no matter what.
It does hurt, yes.
Okay.
But it gets better. Watch the children
play. There's another song. I find it very interesting because you used a sample of Brian Jones' Moroccan recording. How did that idea come about?
Well, actually, that was Hal's idea.
Okay.
But I thought it was a very good idea.
Uh-huh.
Bring Brian onto the record, you know. And it was a perfect song for it, too, Eternity. I find that a very interesting song.
Okay.
Yes.
I read your book from head to toe. I really enjoyed that.
Faithful.
And from your book, I know how much the passing of Brian Jones impacted you.
Oh, God, yes, it did. Yeah.
You even attempted suicide.
I tried to kill myself,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
I mean, that was very stupid. I was doing that because I wanted to punish Mick,
yeah.
you know, of all the idiotic things to
okay.
do. But luckily, I was okay.
Okay.
So very, very grateful I am, yeah.
So much has been said about Brian Jones, but how do you see him as a music man and musician?
I think he was a great musician. Really, really a great musician. I think he had a lot of problems,
mm-hmm.
and that kind of made it very difficult for him.
Mm-hmm. I know it's a very hypothetical question, but how would the Stone be different if he's still around?
Wow, that really is a hypothetical question.
I know.
I don't know. Maybe more of a blues band.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, maybe. More experimental, too.
Maybe more experimental, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we missed him, too.
I don't know. It's sort of impossible to imagine.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
And you turn a girl group classic into something very mature, profound.
Yeah, well, I had to. I am very mature. I'm a great fan of Phil Spector.
Uh-huh.
And a great fan of the Shangri-La.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it would do an interesting spin on that song to do it from my age.
Mm-hmm.
It's a song really about teenage angst,
mm-hmm.
isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
But I wanted to try it, and I think it's okay. Sometimes I like it, sometimes I don't like it. I can tell you it's not really that serious.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a serious song.
I want to hear the children sing.
I read a recent interview about you. I actually saw the interview on your Facebook page.
Yeah.
It's very interesting because you said something like you reach a post-sexual age.
Yeah.
And you're in a stage in your life you decided you don't need a relationship right now.
Yeah.
And that sets you free.
Yeah.
I think that's a very interesting statement because everybody knows you have a very colorful life and you have a very active sexual life.
Yeah.
And that kind of statement coming out from you is very interesting.
Well, I thought it was too. I know people don't usually talk about it. But you know, I mean, what I was feeling was almost pre-sexual.
Yeah.
And then I realized, no, it's post-sexual. That's me.
Okay.
Yeah.
You feel freer now.
Yeah.
You don't have to think about that. You don't need someone to make you happy.
I don't need anybody else in my life to bring me happiness. My happiness comes from inside.
When's the last time you listened to the 60s version of As Tears Go By?
Well, I performed the 60s version on stage.
Mm-hmm.
I don't listen to my old records.
I love both versions.
I love both versions too.
The first version.
But I used to sing the second version for years, and now I've gone back to the first.
Okay. When you listen back to the first version, do you somehow, you know, miss the voice or somehow that girl back in the 60s?
That girl? I'm still the same girl.
But I like that.
Yeah, I haven't changed.
And
I'm just older.
Yeah. And wiser.
I don't know about wiser, but I'm definitely old.
Have you seen the movie Almost Famous?
Yeah.
I loved that movie.
It too, yeah.
And the character played by Kate Hudson, that lovely person, somehow reminded me of you.
Well, we have a little thing in common. But yeah, I mean, it was fabulous. She was fabulous.
Yeah, yeah. She's so lovely. Yeah. One of the lines in the movie is, "We are not groupies. We are band-aids. We came here for music."
Yeah. Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
What do you think about the word groupies?
I don't apply it to myself.
Mm-hmm.
Or band-aid.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that happened to me just seemed to happen by chance. I didn't go out and get it.
Mm-hmm.
I was too young. I was still at school.
Mm-hmm.
I was discovered, I made a record, it all just happened, you know.
It just happened to be there, and everything.
And then I made my own career, and that's what I've gone on doing.
Talk a little bit about your book. I really enjoyed it. I read it from head to toe. And I laughed so loudly, I mean, in some of the chapters. And of course,
it's funny,
says, very funny. You know, some say that your book is a full-on documentary of sex, drugs, and rock and roll, and a lot of sex and drugs.
Mm.
But I think it's an understatement, because I find that it actually documents what it's like to be a woman in the rock world. Because there's there's really a lot of misogyny going on back in the 60s.
Oh, terrible. And now. It's got better.
Does it get really
the
that bad?
The misogyny is not as bad as it used to be, but it's still there.
Yeah. Okay. Do you think that, Lady Gaga, Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, these, you know, pop queens...
I think she's pandering to the misogyny.
Yeah.
She's bringing herself down to the misogyny. They're sort of making herself into a porn star.
Yeah, it's like they're over-sexualizing themselves.
They're doing it to themselves.
Yeah.
They're making themselves groupies.
Yeah, I know. They are still reducing themselves to sexual objects.
Yeah, and that's not feminism.
But are there any, you know, young female musicians, musician, not necessarily
right,
that you like or enjoy listening to?
Yes, I love Polly Harvey.
Okay,
PJ Harvey. I like Lily Allen.
Mm-hmm.
I really like, I think she's wonderful, Amy Winehouse.
Oh, okay.
Very good. And Cat Power, I like. That's about it.
Do you think you share a little bit in common with, you know, what is happening to us Amy Winehouse right now?
No. I mean, and anyway, she's doing it her way. I mean, long, long time ago, maybe.
Hmm.
But it's all very different, you know.
Do you have any good advice for her?
Oh, no, I don't give advice. Ever.
Okay.
Unless somebody asks me.
Okay.
If you asked me for advice, I would honestly give it to you.
Okay.
Doing things I use.
You know that after your show in April, Bob Dylan will be coming to town for the second time.
Yeah.
And also from your book.
Yes.
It mentioned a little bit about there's some sort of unfinished business going on.
No, between we finished. We finished. We see finished. Each other quite often.
Okay.
And we once had a wonderful time in Sydney in a hotel room where we talked and talked and talked. No, we have no unfinished business.
So you're pals now?
Yeah.
Personally, I think that you and Tom Waits are the two of my most beloved husky voices in rock.
Thank you.
So will there be another reunion after the masterpiece Strange Weather?
No.
No? Really?
No. 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 No, Tom is doing his life and I'm doing mine. You know, these kind of things don't happen so much as you get older, really.
Mm-hmm.
Unless they're very phony.
Okay.
Like Frank Sinatra and Bono. Or something like that. But no, no, no.
In your life, you have witnessed firsthand a lot of casualties in rock. Talents wasted, souls lost. As you are being the one of the most legendary survivors in rock and roll history, do you still believe rock and roll can still change the world?
Yeah. I do.
Yeah, I want that yes from you, because I still believe that.
I do. I believe it. And don't forget, no junkie dies in vain. Something is learned from them.
But not from me.
If 60s were a big hangover, would you prefer our digital modern age to be a little bit more drunk?
I think the 70s were a hangover. Yeah, the 60s was just wild. It was wonderful, yeah. Anyway, so, would I prefer it now if everybody was a bit more drunk?
Yeah, a bit more loosened up, like the 60s. Because the 60s was like
a big... It won't come again, you know. It was an almost unique situation. It was something to do with the war, I think. Something to do with the people after the war ended all over the world. Parents wanted their children to have everything and give them a great life.
Mm.
And look how we repaid them, you know. but we were the luckiest generation in the world.
Yeah,
and the children now are not going to get an education or a job. Or it's going to be very, very hard. They must really hate us.
Yeah, we envy you. We don't hate you.
Well, I would say it will turn to hate in the end. And they're living so long, you know, all these old people who should have died, but they didn't.
Thank you so much, Miss Papel.
Okay.
Thank you for inspiring generations and generations to come. Thank you for your music.
Thanks for saying that. Thank you.